problems by elimination. Because the SAT is mostly multiple choice, you don't really have to understand how to transform word problems into equations for a lot of the questions. You can use the answers to your advantage and totally circumvent it. Not sure where to start on a question? Did drawing the situation fall flat? Then take a look at the answer choices. If there are concrete numbers there and not algebraic expressions, then you should try putting some of them through the process that the word problem describes. Like drawing, the process of elimination is often faster than straightforward math. Here is a relatively basic example. Let's give it a shot. At 8 a.m., there are exactly as many chocolate donuts as there are jelly donuts on a table in the teacher's lounge. Within 5 minutes, 15 of the chocolate donuts are eaten, but nobody has eaten the jelly donuts. There are then 4 times as many jelly donuts as there are chocolate donuts on the table. How many jelly donuts are left? A, 5, B, 10, C, 16, D, 20, E, 40. Answer, 20. Explanation. So where should you start? How about with C? After all, neither A nor B is divisible by 4, which the answer probably will be since the number of jelly donuts is 4 times that of the chocolate. And A is definitely too small. In C, there are 16 jelly donuts left, which means there must be 4 chocolate. If there are 4 chocolate donuts after the 5 minutes are up, there must have been 19 at the start. 19 chocolate and 16 jelly don't match up, so that's no good. Let's try D then, so we'll have more jelly donuts. 20 and 20 match up. As you can see with this example, we're done just like that. Once you're practiced with the process of elimination, you'll find that doing it in your head is even faster.